A cube is 3.5 inches on each side. Determine the surface area. A cube is a rectangular solid whose length, width, and height are equal, and therefore each of these six faces is a square as pictured here. The surface area is equal to the number of square units it takes to cover the outside of the cube. The surface area is given by the formula capital S equals 6 times the square of little s, where big S is the surface area and little s is the length of each side. The formula for the surface area should make sense because the surface area equals the sum of the area of the six faces. In the case of a cube, the area of each face is the area of a square given by s times s or s squared, and therefore 6 times s squared does give us the area of all six faces, which is equal to the surface area. In our problem, each side has a length of 3.5 inches, which means this length is 3.5 inches, this length is 3.5 inches, and this length is also 3.5 inches, which means the surface area, capital S, is equal to 6 times the square of little s, which is the square of 3.5 inches. Notice here I did leave the units in the length of the side to emphasize the units of the surface area will be inches squared or square inches. But often the units are left off until the very end, and the surface area is written as S equals 6 times 3.5 squared. Following the order of operations, we first square 3.5, which is 3.5 times 3.5. Before multiplying, notice how the first factor has one decimal place, and so does the second factor. And because 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, the product must contain two decimal places. We first multiply by 5. 5 times 5 is 25. Record the 5. Perform an exchange with the 2. Next, we have 5 times 3 plus 2, which is 15 plus 2, or 17. Before multiplying by the 3, we place a 0 in the rightmost place value below the 5. Multiplying by 3, 3 times 5 is 15. Record the 5. Perform an exchange with the 1. Next, we have 3 times 3 plus 1, which is 9 plus 1, which is 10. Now we add. 5 plus 0 is 5. 7 plus 5 is 12. Record the 2. Perform an exchange. 1 plus 1 is 2. And we have 1. Again, the product must contain two decimal places. Starting to the right of the 5, we move the decimal two places to the left. 1, 2, giving us the product 12.25. The surface area S equals 6 times 12.25. And now to determine this product, let's use the commutative property of multiplication and determine 12.25 times 6. Notice how the first factor has two decimal places, 6 has 0 decimal places, 2 plus 0 is 2, the product must contain two decimal places. Multiplying by 6, 6 times 5 is 30. Record the 0, perform an exchange with a 3. Next we have 6 times 2 plus 3, which is 12 plus 3, or 15. Record the 5, perform an exchange with a 1. Next we have 6 times 2 plus 1, which is 12 plus 1, or 13. Record the 3, perform an exchange with the 1. And finally we have 6 times 1 plus 1, which is 7. The product must contain two decimal places. Starting to the right of the 0, we move the decimal two places to the left, 1, 2. The product is 73.50, or just 73.5, which means the surface area is equal to 73.5 square inches. This tells us it takes 73.5, or 73.5 square inches, to cover the outside of the given cube. Let's also write the result as a complete sentence. The surface area of the cube is 73.5 square inches. I hope you found this helpful.